Shalom class, my name is Innocent Mapanda. I hope I find you well. Welcome to episode 2 of Integration by Substitution. Right. So today we have got integral of e to the power of x divided by 4 minus e to the power of 2x dx, where ln 3 is the upper limit and 0 is the lower limit. Right. So if you are following from the first episode, the first thing or the first stage to do is to make dx the subject of the formula, right? So you have to find the derivative of u with respect to x, right? Since we have got u on the left side, it means that I'm going to write du as my numerator, then dx as my denominator. Right, so the letter on your left side is the one which generates the differential coefficient of the numerator. Then the letter on your right side is the one which generates the differential coefficient of the denominator. Right, so derivative of exponential is good as the exponential itself times the derivative of the power. So e to the power of x times derivative of x is 1, right? So e to the power of x remains e to the power of x, right? So what I'm trying to say is, if you come across with a situation whereby you've got u is equals to 2 e to the power of 5x, and you want to find the derivative of this, you write du dx first, then you write the original function as it is, so that you multiply the original function by the derivative of the power. The power here is 5x, so the derivative of 5x, you get 5. 2 times 5, you get 10, e to the power of 5x, and this is your final answer. So I want you to know that when differentiating exponential functions, you multiply the original function by the derivative of the power. Right, so e to the power of x is the original function. Derivative of x is 1. This is how I have come up with the answer. Right. So to make dx the subject of the formula, you make use of the cross multiplication skill, whereby you multiply both sides by dx. Right. So I'm going to divide du by e to the power of x, so that dx stands on its own, or dx is made the subject of the formula. Right, so this is the stage one, making dx the subject of the formula. So dx is equal to du over e to the power of x. Right, we are now moving on to stage two. Stage two is the change of limits. Right. So, in order to change the limits, you start by preparing a table first. Let me prepare a table like this. So, on the left side, I'm going to put x, right? Then we want to change the limits from x to u. Remember, the substitution is saying u is equal to e to the power of x. So, I want to change everything in x to become u, right? So, the upper limit for the original integral is ln 3. The lower limit for the original integral is 0. So I want to find the value of u when x is equals to ln 3, right? So the first thing to do, I'm going to write u is equals to e to the power of x, right? Then you write u is equals to e to the power of ln 3, since x is equals to ln 3. Right, so I want you to take note of this troubleshooter, right? That if you raise e with ln, take for example, you raise e with a power which is ln 9, you get 9 as your final answer. If you raise e with a power which is ln 20, it means that 20 is your final answer. So the number in front of the ln become your final answer. E to the power of ln 9, you get 9. E to the power of ln 20, you get 20. Right. So, u is equals to e to the power of ln 3. Remember, I want to find the limit of u, which is corresponding to ln 3. Right. So, it means that u is going to become 3, since if you raise an exponential with a Napierian logarithm, you get the number in front of the log as your final answer. So I'm going to place 3 here. Right, then we move on to the next. We want to find the value of u when x is equal to 0. So I'm going to make use of the same expression or same equation or same substitution. U is equal to e to the power of x, right? I'm going to place x on 0. You get u is equal to e to the power of 0. Remember, using the laws of indices, any number raised to the power of 0, it gives you 1. So e to the power of 0, you get 1. So 0 is going to be substituted by 1. So this is how you change your limit. Right, so we are done with the second stage. We have managed to convert the limits of x to become or to obtain the limits of u. Welcome to stage 3. In this stage, we'll be carrying out the process of substitution. Right. So, when substituting, the first thing to substitute are the limits. Right. Remember, ln 3 is now represented by the limit, which is 3. So, on ln 3, I'm going to place 3. Then, 0 is now being represented by a limit of 1. So 1 become your lower limit, right? Then the substitution states that u is equal to e to the power of x. It means that this e to the power of x is going to be substituted by u. So I'm going to place u representing e to the power of x, right? Divided by 4 minus e to the power of 2x is good as ex to the power of 2. E to the power of ex is good as ex in brackets raised to the power of 2. Since ex is being represented by u, it means that e to the power of 2x is good as u squared. I hope you are getting me, class. So on e to the power of 2x, I'm going to write u squared, taking it from here. Right, then you have to multiply everything by dx. Remember, in the first part of the question, we managed to make dx the subject of the formula. So dx, it gives du over e to the power of x. Right, but I want you to notice something, that e to the power of x is good as u. So integral 3, 1, u over 4 minus u squared times du. On ex, I'm going to place u, since u and ex are similar to each other, right? So you can notice that u and u, they cancel out each other. Right, so you'll be left with 1 here. Since u into u, you get 1. You'll be left with 1 divided by 4 minus u squared du, right? So this is the integral that you come out with after the substitution process. Right, welcome back to part 4. In this part, we'd like to integrate 1 divided by 4 minus u squared du. Right, so the first thing to do is to acknowledge that there is a difference of 2 squares. 4 minus u squared. Square root of 4, you get 2. Minus square root of u squared, you get u. But this is difference of 2 squares. It means that the other bracket is going to be represented by 2 plus u du. So it gives what you call partial fractions. So you have to work out 1 over 2 minus u, 2 plus u, to split it using what you call partial fractions. These are linear factors. So the first, you write a divided by 2 minus u, then you introduce b, divided by 2 plus u, making use of what you call the linear factors under partial fractions, right? So this a is going to multiply 2 plus u. Then b is going to multiply 2 minus u, which is identical to this constant or this numerator on your left side, which is 1. Right. So the first thing we'd like to find the value of a when u is equals to 2. Right. When u is equals to 2, if you put 2 on u, it means that the whole bracket at b is going to become 0. So you'll be left out with the a bracket. So it's 2 plus 2 here. Then 2 minus 2, you get 0. So you cannot write 0. You can just leave it like that. So you equate it to 1. Right. 2 plus 2, you get 4, right? 2 plus 2, you get 4. So this is 4a is equals to 1. Then you divide both sides by 4. So you get a is equals to 1 quarter. I hope you are listening, class. Right. Then we move on to the value of b when u is equals to minus 2. So if we use u is equals to minus 2, we'll be able to eliminate this bracket on a. Right. So it means that the whole bracket of a is going to become 0. So you'll be left out with 2 minus, remember u is minus 2. So it's minus minus 2. Is equals to 1 on your right. So negative and negative, they produce a positive sign, giving you 2 plus 2, which is equals to 1. So you get 4b is equals to 1. Then you divide both sides by 4. It gives you b is equals to 1 quarter. Right. So it then implies that you are going to substitute A over 2 minus u plus b over 2 plus u with the constant that you have calculated. So on A, we got 1 quarter, right? So you get 1 quarter divided by 2 minus u. On B, we also got 1 quarter, which is going to be divided by 2 plus u. So you need to work out your integral using this partial fraction, right? So I'm going to integrate. Remember, the upper limit is 3, the lower limit is 1. Then we have got 1 quarter, 2 minus u, plus 1 quarter, 2 plus u, du, right? So when integrating inverse functions, you make use of ln. Right, taking for example, if you have 2 over 2x minus 1 and you want to integrate this, the first thing you have to write 2, which is your numerator, right? Then you divide the numerator 2 by the derivative of the denominator. So derivative of 2x, you get 2, derivative of minus 1, you get 0. So once you create a constant term, it means that it is possible to introduce a ln. So you only introduce a ln provided you have created a constant term first, right? So open bracket 2x minus 1 plus c. This is how you integrate. But if you come across with a situation whereby you have got 2x squared on top and 2x minus 1 at the bottom, right? I want you to notice something. If you write 2x squared as your numerator, then you divide by the derivative of the denominator, which is 2. You are not allowed to introduce a ln. Why? Because 2x squared divided by 2 is not a constant term. So on this type of a question or on this type of an integral, you have to carry out long division first. Why? Because you can only introduce ln provided you have created a constant term first. So you have to take it, you have to take note of that when integrating inverse functions, you only put ln provided the denominator divided by the derivative of the denominator produces a constant term. Without constant term, it means carry out long division first. I hope you are listening, class. Right. So, 1/4 is my numerator. To be divided by the derivative of the denominator. Derivative of 2 is 0, but derivative of minus u, you get minus 1. So, I'm going to divide by minus 1. So, I have the passport. I have the right to introduce ln y. 1/4 divided by minus 1, it produces a constant term. Then you put 2 minus u in modulus, right? So I normally use modulus. Why? Because if you come out with, provided if you substitute 3 on u, you get 2 minus 3, which is negative 1. But there is no ln of a negative number. So negative 1 automatically is going to be treated as positive 1. Because I have made use of the modulus sign representing modulus of 2 minus u. So any negative number automatically is treated as a positive number. I hope you are listening. Right? Then plus 1/4 is the numerator divided by the derivative of the denominator. Derivative of 2, 0. Derivative of u, 1. 1/4 over 1 is a constant term. So I'm going to introduce ln 2 plus u. I hope you are listening, class. Right, so let me simplify it. So this is negative 1/4 ln 2 minus u plus 1/4 divided by 1, you get 1/4 ln 2 plus u. Right, then you then need to substitute upper limit, which is 3, in the expression that you have come out with. So you come out with minus 1/4 ln. Remember, if you substitute u by 3, you get 2 minus 3, which is minus 1. But because you have got modular signs, that minus 1 is going to be treated as 1, since there is no ln of a negative number. Then you say plus 1/4 ln 3 on u, you get 2 plus 3, which gives you 5. Right, we now move on to the next bracket, whereby on every letter of u, we are going to place 1. So minus 1/4 ln 2 minus 1, you get 1, plus 1/4 ln 2 plus 1, you get 3. I hope you are listening, class. Right. So, ln 1, note that ln 1 is always 0. So, it means that minus 1/4 ln 1 becomes 0. So, on this bracket on my left side, I'll be left out with ln, with 1/4 ln 5, since minus 1/4 ln 1 becomes 0. Then, on the negative side, minus 1/4 ln 1 is also going to become 0, since ln 1 represents or denotes a 0. But negative outside the bracket and this plus inside the bracket, they produce a negative sign. So you have negative 1/4 ln 3. I hope you are listening, class. Right, so this is your final answer. You can leave it like that, or if you want, you can factor out 1/4 and you'll be left out with ln 3, ln 5 minus ln 3, which can also be simplified as 1/4 ln open bracket 5 divided by 3, since according to the laws of logarithms, the quotient law, when you subtract, you divide the numbers. So this is your final answer. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Watch out for the next episode, Integration by Substitution. My name is Innocent Mapanda. Have a nice day. Till we meet again. Shalom.